Welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about biostats, the second part. Now in my first video we had spoken about one of the classification of variables. I hope you remember we had divided the variables into quantitative variable and qualitative variable. Today we are going to do the remaining classification of variables. Now second classification, as you can see I put it down on the board for you, is variables can be classified either into continuous variable or discrete variable. What does continuous variable mean? Continuous variables means those variables that can have many possible values and also they can take up in between values. And what are discrete variables? Those variables which can take up, which have fewer values and no in between values. So what does this exactly mean? Now look at the first example that I've put down for you. Weight. Somebody's weight can be 80 kg. Somebody's weight could be 110 kg. Somebody's weight could also be 80.4 kg. So the weight can take up many values. Also in decimals it could be the in-between values. Similarly for height, somebody's height could be 110 cm. Somebody's height could be 120 cm. Somebody's height could be 110.5 cm. So it can take up many values, also in between values. Similarly, blood sugar level can take up, somebody's could be 120 mg per deciliter. We have glucometers that could also measure 120.5 mg per deciliter. Now, so what are discrete variables? As I put down, they take up fewer values and no in between values. So example, suppose we talk about blood group. If I ask you what is your blood group, you will answer me as A, B, AB or O. Right? This is what the answer will be. Either of these. You cannot lie in between A and B. You cannot lie in between B and AB. You will have a particular blood group, either A or B. Similarly, let's take up the example of gender. Gender, either you will be male or female. You cannot lie in between male and female. Any disease, if you talk about, say obesity, you will either be obese or you will not be obese. You cannot lie in between being obese and not being obese. Similarly, let's talk about anemia. In anemia, you can either be anemic, which is yes or no. You cannot lie between being anemic and not being anemic. Similarly, for example, if we have hemoglobin level, you will have exact values. A lot of values could come. 12.5, 11.5, even it's possible to have in between values. Now, our next classification of variables is, it can be divided into two types. One is dichotomous variable or binary variable and the other is polyautomous variable. What do you mean by dichotomous? It means that a variable can take up only two values. And what do you mean by a polyautomous variable? It means that a variable can take up more than two values. Okay, now let us see example. If I ask you about ABO blood group, again, it can be either A positive, B positive, AB or O. So it can take up more than two values. But if we talk about say Rh blood group, it can only be, your status can be Rh positive or Rh negative. So it can take up only two values. Let's talk about presence of hypertension or presence of any disease. It can be two values only. Either the disease will be present or absent. Similarly, gender. Only two, if we say gender could be male or female. Right? Polyautomous, another example is suppose weight and height. Okay? So weight can take up more than two values. Like weight could be 80 kgs, 80.5 kgs, a number of values. But if I ask you weight more than 80 kg, suppose, then this would only be yes or no. Okay, so polyautomous means it can take up many values and dichotomous means it has only two values. Okay, now moving to the next part, it is the scales of measurement. That is, the question comes like weight should be measured on which scale? Or blood group should be measured on which scale? So variables, for variables we have various scales of measurement. The broad classification is, it could be a categorical scale or it could be measured in a dimensional scale. Under categorical scale, we have two headings, nominal scale and ordinal scale, and under dimensional scale, we have metric scale. Now, what do you mean by nominal? You can see from the first part only, you will understand. Nominal means it is a scale which is based on names. Ordinal means ORD. It is a scale which is based on order. And metric means it is based on measurement. So now, a few examples. Suppose I take you, religion as a variable should be evaluated under which scale? So it is nominal scale. Religion could be Hindu, Muslim, Christian. Similarly, blood group, it is based on names. So it will be measured under nominal scale. Similarly, gender or sex of a newborn. For example, now for ordinal scale, suppose we talk about the severity of cancer or the severity of any disease. Now, we can establish an order in such cases. So, for variables where you can establish an order, those are measured by ordinal scale. I've put down options for you. Suppose I ask you cancer, presence of cervical cancer. Either the answer would be yes or no. So, presence of cervical cancer would be based on nominal scale. But if I ask you staging of cancer, you can establish an order. That would be an ordinal scale. Okay. Now, the third is metric scale. This is based on measurements. Very simple. So, where we can get exact measurements like weight, height, BP, hemoglobin level, all those are based on metric scale. So now, out of this you can see that basically nominal and ordinal scale are for which type of data? This is for qualitative data. And metric scale is for which type of data? This is for quantitative data. Okay, now an MCQ question that comes is, which is the most preferable scale of measurement? It is, of course, metric scale. And which is the least preferable scale of measurement? It is nominal scale. Okay. Now, one question that has come as an MCQ is pulse rate. Whether it is a continuous variable or a discrete variable. Now, pulse rate, guys, is a continuous variable. How? Suppose you're asked to count the pulse rate. You often tell it 72 beats per minute or 70 beats per minute. But if you see the ICU monitors, they give you pulse rate in exact decimals also. It's just the limitation of our human mind that we cannot count in decimal points. Also, if I ask you to say count the pulse rate for 2 minutes instead of 1, it comes out to be say 130 beats per minute. So in 1 minute it will be about 135 beats per minute. So in 1 minute it will be, you will divide it by 2, it will come out to be 62.5. So please remember this. Now, one thing more that comes as MCQ is, suppose I give you weight. What we have studied, a quick revision, weight is, whether it's a qualitative or quantitative variable, it's a quantitative variable. Then whether it's a continuous or discrete variable, it's a continuous variable. It can take up many values. Whether it's a polyotomous or dichotomous, it's a polyotomous variable. Now let's take another example. Suppose blood group. So blood group, is it a quantitative or qualitative variable? It's a qualitative variable. We cannot exactly measure how much of A positive a person is. It's a continuous or discrete variable? It's a discrete variable. Why? Because it can pick up fewer values. And is it a polyotomous or dichotomous variable? It is a polyotomous variable. So you could be given any variable and you could be asked to mark the correct option. So I hope I've tried to explain you about the variables and the scales of measurement. We'll be coming again next video. Till then, if you have any comments, please drop in the comment section below.